Hello. Hello. Hello, everybody. My name is Anna Dixon, and today we will talk about all about eyebrows. So we create a new online course, and I combine all technique together. And this is my present for Christmas, which is coming soon. So this course will include soft powder technique, ombre brows technique, dots technique. Also, we will talk about shape and henna, and of course, we will talk about pigments because every time I have a lot of questions about pigments. So, in this online course, we will talk about pigments also. Let me explain you why I decide to combine these techniques together. Because for master, it's very important to choose right technique, especially when you see your clients and you need to see the skin types. And it's very nice to have options because not all techniques match to all skin types. And sometimes we are just know like one or two technique, and this is not enough. Because we don't understand why sometimes it does not work. So, what I want to teach you, it's how to choose right technique and right case. Because, for example, we have clients with very difficult skin types. It's not that it means that skin is bad or something, but it's much more difficult for us for work with the difficult skin types. It can be oily skin, it can be very thin skin, like super thin, and it's very difficult to catch the right depth and implant the pigment with the maximum effect. So what I'm trying to do during my work, hello, during my work, I'm trying to find the perfect technique for this case. And my favorite trick for difficult skin types, like for difficult cases, is the dots technique. I create this technique in this year, especially for my beginner student who just start their career and just start to work with the shading. So they want to do ombre style, like makeup effect for dramatic looking eyebrows, because lots of our clients want to get a visible effect. But by some reasons they have no good equipment or not have a good skills yet. So I really wanted to teach them how to do the beautiful ombre eyebrows, but I understood that they're limited by options, and the most reason it's equipment. And it's like I was thinking like, oh my God, how I can help them, because some of them have very simple permanent makeup pen, like very cheap and not really powerful, but they want to learn ombre style. And I created dots technique. So dots technique, which you can learn in this all about online course, all about eyebrows online course in this month. Dots technique, it's combination of two technique. It's manual shading and dots by machine. Manual shading, it's understandable. So we just take a manual needle, group needle, and we are working by typing movements, and we create the shading. Shading always gives you a very dense color, like very visible. And the shading, manual shading, what is good about this technique, because you can create very dense color for any type of skin. So it's very easy to control the depth, and it also gives you a maximum effect no matter what. And it's very easy to control the depth by choosing the bigger size of the needle. For example, manual shading helps me a lot to work with a sensitive skin. You know, but sometimes our clients has a very, very thin skin, and you just lightly touch it and it's bleeding. And you are doing one pass and it's bleeding, it's nothing. And you're wiping and you like you can see the color into the skin. And then you are doing second pass and it looks like we're just scratching the skin and damage the skin, open the skin, but we can't see the color into the skin. So manual shading helps, because compare machine, it's like, can you imagine speed of the machine? Sometimes it's like 5,000, 7,000 or 15,000 rotation per minute, and manual is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so it's like maybe 60 or I don't know, 200 maximum per minute. So it's much, much slower. And every tap is effective. So we are not touching the skin so many times compared machine. And manual shading is much less damaged for the skin compared machine shading. And if you take a bigger size of the needle, you can work super surface, and if you work a little bit slower, you will get a pigment into the skin even when skin is super, super thin. I use this technique a lot for sensitive skin types, especially for women with a like oily skin, but at the same time it's sensitive, you know, with a real, really pink cheeks. You can understand that blood vessels is located on very, very surface into the skin. So we just taking do you work with the flat needles? Yes, it can be flat needle, but it's two rows of the needle, so it's like this way, and it's number 14 or something like that. Also, I'm working with a circle needle. I love soft top needle a lot. My favorite needle is number 8, so it's 8 round needle, and it's sloped like that, so it's not like a flat, it's like this, and it's very useful when you type in like this direction. Also, soft top has a very nice needle, number 18 or things. Let me double check, so you can text me privately and I will find the information for you. I think it's 18 14, something around this, and it's very, very work for very sensitive skin type. So when 18 needle touch the skin at the same time, it's impossible to go too deep because it's too many of them, and with less amount of needle, it's easier to go deeper. But when it's a lot of them, you will be on the surface anyway. And also soft top, they have a curved needle. It's also double row, and I think it's 14. So it's also very, very useful, and it's very useful for this line, on the bottom line of the beginning of eyebrow and this part, so you can create a super clear bottom line for very dramatic looking effect. And I really love these needles. So if your machine is not good, or maybe you just start to learn shading, I highly recommend to learn the manual shading, because it helps a lot. So you don't need to control the depth by your skills or changing the movements. You just change the size of the needle and you can work more surface or deeper. What's the problem about manual shading? So manual shading is never even enough and never transparent enough. So I'm kind of perfectionist, and I love when beginning of eyebrow looks like super smooth with super smooth gradient and not spotty. So beginning of eyebrow and upper part of eyebrow supposed to be perfectly natural looking, like makeup, like soft powder makeup. And with manual shading, it's impossible to get it because this is a needle. It's like pam 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 pam, so it's always a little bit spotty. It's okay for get a dense color in the middle of eyebrow or tail because it's not really important and it's a lot of color, so all of these spots come on top of each other and we can create even color, but it will be dense. But on the beginning of eyebrow, we need more fluffy, more transparent looking, and that's why I created dots technique. So dots technique is about single needle. It's little single needle, and we are working like with movements which looks like Parkinson's disease. So we're just tuk, 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 and it's like all dots are separate, but because we shake our hand, it's a lot of dots, like hundreds of them. And by this little tiny dots, we create the pixels effect, which looks kind of similar like soft powder. But for soft powder technique, we need a very, very good quality of equipment. You need a perfect pigment, you need a good skin, I mean you need a good candidate for soft powder. So it's a lot of but for soft powder technique, but with dots it's very simple. Dots works for any type of skin, and dots helps me a lot for oily skin, thick skin, sensitive skin, any type. And also for dots technique, we don't need a special equipment or something because it's just single needle and this is your skills. And also you don't need to have a very, very good skills because you can work like super fast if you have a good experience and your skills is super good, or it will take just a little bit longer time, so you'll do like dot by dot, dot by dot, but any case it's just about time, but the result will be beautiful because it's not so difficult to work with the dots technique. So combine two methods together, like manual shading for middle part and bottom line, and dots technique for beginning of eyebrow and upper part, we create the perfect combination which helps you give a good color, dense color in the middle, and super fluffy and transparent color on the beginning of eyebrow and upper line. So two of these methods helps you to create the perfect looking eyebrows, and you can guarantee your clients a good healed result, and you as a master can be quiet that eyebrows of your client will be looks good and your clients will be satisfied about getting the procedure from you. So dots technique helps a lot for beginners who just start to learn shading, especially after microblading. It helps for beginners who just start Korean permanent makeup and even don't know the microblading yet. Also, dots technique helps experienced artists who sometimes confused with the difficult cases for oily skin, sensitive skin, skin rich of collagen, like dark skin type. So all of us, we have some trouble sometimes and difficult cases, and if nothing helps, dot will help. And also this technique is really good if you just start your career as a teacher and you want to help your students because sometimes they're struggling and they don't know how to avoid the difficult situation. So if you're teaching your students and want to help them, you can show this little trick, and this is really, really useful. And I recommend to learn by dots. This is the first, like basic stuff. And the next level is ombre. For ombre, we don't need like very special equipment, but equipment supposed to work well. Ombre style, it's a technique with a group needle. It's my favorite technique for shading because ombre style always helps you to keep the skin very protected because no matter how good you are, microblading a permanent makeup, it's always create micro scars into the skin. And I truly believe that we are the masters of permanent makeup. We need to care about skin of our clients because as much procedures we've done, as much micro scars our clients have into the skin. And after time, after 5, 7 procedures, it's very difficult to work on the skin again. And it's much difficult to cover up previous work. So why I love ombre? Because ombre style, this is the most surface, the most gentle, and the most protecting the technique compare all other technique and permanent makeup. And most of our clients really like to get a dense color. So they call it this naturally, but it's like I want a natural looking eyebrows, but actually they mean exactly like dramatic looking. Just this dramatic looking supposed to look like professional makeup. It mean not look like a fake, and that's why they call it natural effect. 90% or even 99% of our clients beauty motivated, and they won't look. So they want eyebrows look like they have a makeup on it. It's mean a lot of color, especially on the bottom line and the middle part of eyebrows. And for create very dense color, we need to work with a group needle because this is the smartest and quickest way. And my favorite needle is 3-round liner, but also I love to work with a curve magnum and sometimes round shader, but it's a little bit more dramatic. But for some skin types, it's possible to use shaders. So I will show you how to work with the group needles and how to choose the pigments for ombre style. Because when we create a dramatic looking, it's very important to choose the right pigment. Because if you have visible eyebrows and they will turn to red after 6 months, it's not really good for our reputation. And so we will talk about pigments. This online course also will include lots of knowledge about pigments, how to choose the color properly, structure of pigments, difference between organic and inorganic. I will show you the way I'm picking the pigments and why. I will show you the difference. It's like between tattoo organics and minerals pigments. The minerals turn to red after time and organic turn to blue after time, like cold away. It's like how to pick the pigment. And also some techniques like hair strokes or microblading or dots technique, it's a deeper compare ombre and soft powder, for example. And if you will take the same color for different technique by the depth, color will be different after healing. So with ombre and soft powder, color always a little bit warmer because this technique is more surface. And with microblading and dots and deeper technique like hair strokes by machine, for example, also color needs to be a little bit more, is need to be warmer because this technique going deeper into the skin. So about all of this, we will talk in this on new online course all about eyebrows. And also we will talk about shape because technique is really important, of course. We will talk about machines, we will talk about movements, we will talk about pigments, needles, all of this. But this is nothing without shape. Eyebrows, it's about shape. We need to learn how to do it properly. We need to learn how to do it naturally and individual. This is a key for me as a master. All eyebrows on my clients looks different. They are individual. They match only for this client. And I will teach you how to read the lines of the face and how to create the harmony looking eyebrows for your clients. We will talk about style, we will talk about shape, we will talk about these lines. I will show you the quick way to draw eyebrows, and also I will show you how to work his henna a little bit, because eyebrows with henna looks much more beautiful. I think that permanent makeup and henna is like really, really, really best friends, like permanent makeup and lashes. So there is a couple of perfect combination, and henna is one of these. So eyebrows with permanent makeup and henna for coloring the natural hair of eyebrows together looks very, very beautiful. So it's a lots of things which we need supposed to talk, and also we will talk about soft powder. Soft powder is my favorite technique, but soft powder, so first it's going dots technique, then it's ombre, and next level it's soft powder. Soft powder is the most difficult technique compared to all other shading technique and permanent makeup, because for soft powder technique you need to have a good machine. This is really important. It's possible to do the soft powder technique by low power machines. You will just scratch the skin without no reason, no result. So we need a good equipment, and we will talk about it. It's like how to choose a good equipment. It's not about price, and I will show you the way how to choose a good equipment for a reasonable price. So good equipment. Also, it's supposed to be right pigment, because soft powder technique, it's like a pixels effect, and pixels are really visible only with high concentrated pigment. So if you're working with pigment which is not really concentrated, you will work, but you will not see the color into the skin. So we will talk about pigment, we will talk about consistency of the pigment, because for soft powder it's really important to choose the right consistency, and it depends what you prefer. You will prefer work with a high lens, like a long needle, or you like to work with a short needle. And for long needle, consistency of the pigment, it's just about the length of the needle. For long needle, I prefer to work with the watering consistency. For short needle, it's better to work with thick consistency. And we will talk about movements, because soft powder, it's all about movements. So it's all about technique, and your skills supposed to be good. You need to be experienced to work effectively with soft powder. Why? Because soft powder technique is all about single needle, and when we are working with a single needle going into the skin like knife in the butter, nothing can stop her compare group needle, which is impossible to go too deep. So group needle always helps you to keep the right depth, not going too deep. Single needle going into the skin super easy, because it's just one needle. And why needle? We need a powerful device, because with powerful device we can do the fast long movements, and fast long movements help us do not go too deep into the skin. So we are working super, super fast, and the needle like lightly touch the surface of the skin. And because needle has no too much time to go into the skin too deep, by this case we are working surface. So all of this together, and all of this, I will explain you all of this process, and you will understand why it's so important to do it perfectly and make a right choice for pigment, equipment, needles, movements, and also perfect candidate for this type of procedure because soft powder, it's possible to work for any type of skin, but it depends on your skills. But if skills is not like perfect, it's better to choose a good candidate for this type of procedure, and we will talk about it, and I will show you how to see the difference for transparent, not transparent skin types, rich of collagen or no, dry or oily. We will talk about all of this. So it's a lot of things which we need to discuss, and please welcome to my new online course for all about eyebrows. I will send you the link so you can check all information on my website, and also we have a special discount for this month, and it's $30 off. Please check comments below this video and get this coupon for get your discount. And I hope to see you in the new group. In this month, we will start in 5th December. So please welcome. I hope to see all of you in this group all about eyebrows. With love, your Anna Dixon. Bye.